बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम। आई एम प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर महमूदा बेगम, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एनाटॉमी, आदिनोमिक्स मेडिकल कॉलेज, मगबाजार, ढाका। कम बैक विथ न्यू वीडियो ऑफ ऑनलाइन टीचिंग एनाटॉमी ऑफ वर्टिब्रल कॉलम। द स्लाइड शोइंग द डिफरेंट पर्सन सफरिंग फ्रॉम द पेन ऑन द बैक साइड, दैट इज द लो बैक पेन। दिस इज द figure, it's a vertebral column. They are showing the pathology in the lumbar region. And this is the older person, normal, usually suffering from the normal back pain. And this is a different posture which causes the back, low back pain. So most clinical disorder of the back present as low back pain with or without associated lower limb pain, weakness or numbness. So I like to let you know about the anatomy of the vertebral column. Vertebral column has great importance in the pathology of the lumbar lower vertebral region on the back, but it is most neglected. This anatomy has been neglected, but recent 2005 scientist Budakt has sufficient work about this soft tissue and bony elements of the vertebral column. So, but the bony framework in the vertebral column, which consists the axial skeleton like the vertebral column occiput, and also the elements of the pectoral, pelvic girdle and ribs. Let us start our discussion on the anatomy of the vertebral column. This is model of vertebral column. It actually curved linkage individual bones like the vertebra, and when these are there articulated, then articulated the individual vertebra, they form a vertebral column. For this reason, the individual vertebra, they have a foramen. So when this articulated, it form a continuous series, and collectively it is known as the vertebral canal. And on the lateral side, there is a paired foramen known as the intervertebral foramen. And the individual segment, there is a segment of the cervical segment, thoracic segment, lumbar segment and sacral. And individual segment, they have the vertebra, the individual identifications, characteristics, but they can join the neighboring vertebra, adjacent vertebra can articulate the in between. There is a important structure, intervertebral discs. So these are the articulated vertebral column. Now the function of the vertebral column. Vertebral columns give support the trunk and also protect the spinal cord and its nerves and also meninges, and provide attachment of the muscle, and also it is important site of the hemoptysis throughout the life. Now important canal, this is the vertebral canal. Vertebral canal we mentioned before, this is the vertebral canal. This canal is behind the body of the vertebra, but body of the vertebra this canal is present. And this canal extend from the occiput foramina magnum to the sacral hiatus. And also this vertebral canal follow the curvature of the vertebral column. And now the content of the vertebral canal. This is the epidural space. This is in between the periosteum of the vertebra and the meninges of the spinal cord. This is the epidural space, and this space contains the connective tissue, loose connective tissue and fat. And this is the spinal cord, and there are nerve roots. This is the spinal nerve and nerve roots, and there are also present the spinal vessels and internal vertebral venous plexus. This is the content of the vertebral canal. For the purpose of the clinical importance, vertebral canal can divided into three zones. One is the central zone. This zone is present in between the medial margin of the facet joints and two lateral joints which lies beneath the facet joint. And these lateral zones can enter in the intervertebral foramen. So they can communicate with the intervertebral foramen. The morphology of the vertebral column. Morphology of the vertebral column. These are the shape, anterior aspect of the vertebral column, anterior aspect, and this anterior aspect showing the body, that is the body of the vertebra. They form the anterior aspect, and also there is a lateral grouped on the both side of the body. This is the anterior view, anterior aspect of the vertebral column. And this is the lateral view. This is the lateral view or lateral side of the vertebral column. This actually formed by the transverse process and intervertebral foramen. Transverse process and intervertebral foramen. And this view showing the curvature of the vertebral column is not a straight column. There is a curve. Synonymously, it is a curved structure. And when it is viewed posteriorly, the posterior view, it is formed mainly by the spinous process and the lamina. Spinous process. So there is this morphology of the vertebral column. This one of the vertebral column can influenced it by external and internal factor. External factor, that is a mechanical or environmental, but internal factor, this is the metabolic, genetics, and also the hormonal factor. All these factors affect the ability to react to the dynamic force of the everyday life, just such as the compression, traction, and shear. And these dynamic force much in magnitude, mass magnitude, and is also influenced by the locomotion, occupation, and the posture of the individual. Now the component, how the vertebral column is formed, we already mentioned there is a vertebral column, there is a adult vertebral column, there is a usually they consist of 30 from atlas to sacrum. There is a coccyx, there are about 33 vertebra, 33 segment of the vertebra. The number in the cervical region, the number about the 7 cervical vertebra, and in the thoracic region there is a 12 thoracic vertebra, and the lumbar region there is a 5 thoracic lumbar vertebra, and the sacral region, there is a 5 sacral vertebra can united to form a sacrum, and there is a 4 coccyx. So this number total is the 33. This number can be vary from the 32 to 35. And there is a two conditions there occur. One is known as the sacralization, and one is the lumbarization. Sacralization is the condition, the congenital anomalies, when the fifth lumbar vertebra is fused with the fifth lumbar vertebra can fuse with the sacrum, first sacrum. It is the congenital. Our lumbarization, if there is a first and second sacral vertebra does not fuse, so there appear in the sixth lumbar vertebra. It is known as the lumbarization. Okay, and each presacral vertebra can separate it from neighboring adjacent vertebra by a structure, important structure. It is known as the intervertebral discs, intervertebral fibrocartilages, intervertebral discs. Now measurement of the vertebra. The length of the vertebra in case of the male about 70 centimeter, and in case of the female it is about 60 centimeter. And there the intervertebral discs can also contribute the formation of the length. About one quarter of the total length, about one quarter of the length, it is formed by the intervertebral discs. And the different segment, their contribution about the cervical region, which contribute 80% of the total length, and cervical region 20%, and lumbar region 12%, and sacrococcygeal region about 8%. Now the important structure intervertebral disc. What is intervertebral disc? Intervertebral disc is important for functioning, normal functioning of the vertebra. It is a cushion of the fibrocartilaginous disc, and it is principally, it form a joints in between the body of the vertebra, and there are about 23 discs present in the human vertebra. 6 for the cervical region, 12 for the thoracic region, and 5 for the lumbar region. Importance of the vertebral discs. The vertebral discs allow the vertebra to flexible without sacrificing a great deal of strength, and it also provide a shock absorbing effect within the vertebra and prevent the vertebra from the grinding together. Now the parts of the intervertebral discs, there were 3 parts from the center to periphery. The centrally, there present the nucleus pulposus. This is the nucleus pulposus, and it is actually a gel-like structure, and structurally it is a collagen fiber, and maximum it about 60 to 87% is the water, others is the collagen fibers, and it gives the strength and the flexibility of the vertebral column. Second is the peripheral annulus fibrosus. These are the concentric lamellar of the collagen fibers, and this lamella is alternative, so it gives more restriction of the multi-directional movements. And this is the third is the end plate, cartilaginous end plate of the adjacent vertebra. This gives the nutrition for the vertebral discs. This is the 3 parts of the intervertebral discs. Now the curvature of the vertebral column. This curvature from the beginning, from the intrauterine life to the adult, the curvature is very flexible, and there is 2 types of curvature. First is the primary curvature, second is the secondary curvature. Okay, so for primary curvature, this is the embryonic life or the fetal period. This curvature is totally single and flexed, that is concavity is forward, and there are 2 primary curvature, thoracic and pelvic curvature is developed. And after that, the secondary curvature is developed due to the functional muscles developments, which leads to the formation of the secondary curvature, that is lumbar and cervical curvature. And neonatal, due to the neonatal periods, the neonatal curvature is not no fixed curvature. It is the flexible in conditions, and so it can bend in any direction. So it can easily bend into a perfect half circle in fashion. Okay, this is the neonatal curvature. But in the infant usually, we know the infant usually can hold our head at the 3 to 5 month, and also in sit upright around the 9 month, and they will commence working about 12 to 15 months. This a functional variation can causes and influence the development of the secondary curvature, influence the secondary curvature. And also during this time, that the size of the vertebra also variable, preferably in the lumbar region. And the lumbar secondary curvature also important, gives importance in maintaining the center of gravity of the trunk over the legs, so when start the walking. In adult, what are the curvature present? In adult, there is a 4 curvature present. In the cervical region, it is a like the lordosis, that is the convexity forward. And this curvature extend from the atlas to the second thoracic vertebra. And this is the apex of this curvature is at the level of the third, fourth and fifth cervical spine. And this is the thoracic curvature. Thoracic curvature start from the 3rd to 11th and 12th thoracic vertebra, and the apex at the level of the 6th and 9th thoracic vertebra, and this is the kyphosis, that is convexity backwards. The lumbar curvature, it is or another lordosis, that is convexity forwards, and it is the apex at the level of the third lumbar vertebra. And there is the last is the pelvic curvature, it is concavity anterior inferiorly. It formed by the lumbosacral angle to the apex of the coccyx. Now this vertebral column in elderly, what are the changes occurred in the elder age of the vertebral column? Like this is the in old people, that this age related changes is occur in the structure of the vertebra that leads to broadening and loss of height of the vertebral column body. So this is the change is most focused on the female, in the female, and the deformity like this, the Dogger's hump. This is the Dogger's hump, and the mid thoracic region kyphosis is more, and lordosis of cervical region is the more, and it is associated with the osteoporosis. Now, how the vertebral column gets their nutrition? That is the vascular supply and lymphatic drainage. Vascular supply, this is artery of the vertebral column, comes from the in the thoracic and the lumbar region. They are the posterior intercostal artery and lumbar artery. But in the cervical and the sacral region, they are present the longitudinal artery. This longitudinal artery anastomosis and ultimately give the branch, spinal branch, which give supply the posterior aspect of the vertebral column. Venous drainage. Veins of the vertebral column form intricate plexus along the entire column, and external and internal to the vertebral canal. Both groups are devoid of valve, and then anastomosis freely with each other above and join the intervertebral veins. There is another important vein. They are present within the canal. On the body of the vertebra, posterior aspect of the body of the vertebra, that is basivertebral vein. This basivertebral vein is a pair and bulbous. They also communicate through this venous, this vertebral vein can communicate with the dural venous sinus. Now the lymphatic drainage. Lymphatic drainage follow the artery supply, and the segmental, the cervical vertebra column drain into the deep cervical lymph node, thoracic region it drain in the posterior intercostal lymph node, lumbar region are drain in the lateral aortic and retro aortic lymph nodes, and last is the pelvic part of the column drained to the lateral, sacral and the internal iliac lymph node. Now innervation of the vertebral column. Innervation of the vertebral column comes from the spinal nerve. Where they are branches in and just beyond the intervertebral foramen, and is also input from the sympathetic system, either via gray rami communicates or directly from the thoracic sympathetic ganglia. So the linkage of the vertebral column, first is the vertebra, and another is the linkage is done by the ligament and muscles. So ligaments of the vertebral column, there is above ligament, anterior longitudinal ligament, there are the anterior longitudinal ligament, and also this is the anterior longitudinal ligament, this is the anterior longitudinal ligament, and this ligament is strong and provide protections to displacement of the vertebra, because there is the important clinical condition, herniation of the discs. It is mostly prevented by the anterior longitudinal ligament. Another is the posterior longitudinal ligament, is attached the posterior surface of the body of the individual vertebra. And there is another important ligament, the lamina, there is present the ligamentum flava. Ligamentum flava is also present there. And there is a spinous interspinous ligament presence, ligamentum flava, this is the lamina propria, this is the lamina propria, there present the ligamentum flava, this is a lamina, and this is the spinous interspinous, and also the transverse ligament, intertransversus ligament. These are the ligaments of the vertebral column. Now the muscle, which are the muscles act on the vertebral, actually their muscle act on the vertebral column. This is known as the true or intrinsic muscle. These muscles share origin and the nerve supply can indicate this is the intrinsic or the true muscle, because the true muscle is characterized by their position and their innervation by the branches of the dorsal rami of spinal nerve. What are the movements occur in the vertebral column? If the single vertebra, this is the single vertebra, the movement is less, but when the total articulated vertebral column, there is a long range of the movement. Movement like the flexion and extension mostly occur in the cervical and lumbar region, and this is the lateral flexion and extension. This is the bending of the vertebral column. It is mostly occur in the cervical and lumbar region, and there is the axial rotation. Axial mostly occur in the thoracic region. So this is the different movement occurs in the vertebral column. Now, what are the deformity present in the vertebral column? If there is a lateral bending of the vertebral column like this, this is the lateral bending. This is known as the scoliosis. And if there is a more dorsal convexity occur, this is the kyphosis. And also if there is a lordosis is accentuated, so it is also known as the lordosis. There is a different deformity like the scoliosis, kyphosis, and lordosis. And how we can identify there is the vertebral column in the X-ray or radiology. This is the radioanatomy. This is the vertebral column, showing the vertebral column. This is the lumbar region. There focus the body of the vertebra, that is spinous process of the vertebra. And because bones is the radiological shadow, bones is the radio opaque. And in between there is presence, in between there is a radio, like this, the radiolucent of the soft tissue shadow. This is the intervertebral discs. So this is the in between the two vertebrae is a gap, because the gap is occupied by the intervertebral discs. These are the intervertebral discs, and this is the body of the vertebral spinous process, intervertebral foramen. This is the intervertebral foramen. Okay. And in our the torso, we are also, these are the intervertebral foramen. This intervertebral foramen transmit, you know, there is interspinal branches of the spinal nerve, respective spinal nerve. And on the right side, this vertebral column is the cervical region. So there is a numbering of the cervical vertebra 1, 2, 3, 4. And the back, this is the soft tissue shadow. And this is the lateral view, and this is the anteroposterior view. That's all today. See you in the next session. Please take care of yourself. Stay safe. Allah Hafiz.